Brigadier 4th Infantry Division Commander, Brigadier Boni Bamuswechi, has ordered the security apparatus that are implementing the presidential directives during the current 42-day countrywide lockdown to stop the movement of hawkers in Gulu. The Army General is worried that hawkers are spreading COVID-19 in communities as they move from door to door. Our reporter has more.
They are infiltrating us. Why they don't stay in their own place? One, who checks them? Whether they have COVID, whether they don't have COVID.
Speaking during the regional COVID-19 task force meeting at the 4th Infantry Division barracks in Gulu City, Brigadier General Boni Bamuswechi issued orders that the movement of hawkers be put on hold. He is worried that these hawkers are spreading the disease in the communities.
Now people, the buses are not working, the taxis are not working. How do those hawkers come from Kampala to Gulu? There must be some other ways of infiltration. Either these people come by these other lorries, which tries to dodge, but I've known that. Now I'm going to deploy most of the panniers.
The directives come at a time when Gulu City and District are registering a higher COVID-19 death rate than the national average.
In Gulu, yeah, mortality rate is 2.14%. And if we are to compare with the national mortality rate, which is at 1.01%, ours is high. And for now, we are trying to find out why we are having higher mortality rate compared to the national.
Dr. Kenneth Kana, the acting Gulu District Health Officer, says of 470 patients that are undergoing treatment, 51 are battling for their lives in the intensive care unit.
37 in La Chau, and out of these 37, as I talk now, 30 are in need of oxygen and they are being provided oxygen. Gulu Regional Referral Hospital, currently they are about 14 cases and 9 are on oxygen.
The Amuru District Resident Commissioner, Osborne Ocheng, also called on the security under the 4th Infantry Division Commander to put in check charcoal and timber dealers who drive their lorry vehicles late in the night throughout the villages.
The lead enforcer of this presidential directive is the Uganda Police Force. And now having a regional meeting like this, we are calling in the sister security agencies, more especially the UPDF, to come in the rescue of these gaps created by the thin number of forces from Uganda Police Force.
The commander has pledged to increase the manpower of security officers implementing the presidential directives in the fight against the coronavirus. This story was compiled by Joseph Omago for the news in Gulu City.